Welcome to Suncoast View. I'm Stephanie Roberts. Liquor could be easier to find in Florida. And does being attractive actually make it harder to make a love connection? We'll discuss.
I'm beauty expert Mickey Williams. It's hard to stick to a diet, especially if you're hungry all the time. Today, I brought a new FDA-approved weight loss system that keeps you feeling full so you eat less.
I'm Bo Beth. Swimsuit season is here, and we'll have the latest fashions from a Suncoast designer on our runway.
And I'm Linda Carson. From Hollywood to right here on the Suncoast, actor and comedian Sinbad sits down with us to have some fun. All that and more right now on Suncoast View.
Welcome to the show, and welcome back to our good friend, Mickey Williams.
Hey,
we love it when you come down.
Yeah, it's really been a while. I missed you guys.
Yeah,
I
got caught. You had a long stint in New York.
I know. I actually redid my apartment.
Wow.
I was like, why not? I know. I wasn't going to go outside and, you know, jump or ski, so I figured. I did get a really big snowstorm, though.
Yes, you were there for the big one.
Well, I went sledding.
We always like to look
at social
media.
Did you mean to go sledding?
I did. You go sledding at Central Park.
We found on social media that you've also been doing some work with HSN and your hair to wear. I love seeing you all glammed up with all your hair. And in the same note, we like to find things like fuzzy slippers.
That's when I first got home, and I have like 15 pairs of slippers. Aww. I really do.
Those look comfortable.
I leave a pair waiting for me for when I get off the road, and they're the first thing I do. I put my slippers on. So. Yeah, those are my Poochie Magics right there.
I thought you were wearing them working. I was so impressed.
I do because I work from home. So I literally am on conference calls all day trying to be glamorous. But I'm really wearing like unicorn or puppy dog slippers or pig slippers.
Do you have all your makeup on?
Unless it's like a conference call, and then I'm just right up from here, like, you know, Skype or anything like that. It's horrible.
The things that we don't see that happen from people who work at home, I absolutely love it. So, and Bo Beth usually doesn't have pants on, right?
Yeah,
isn't
right.
that what you don't see from sitting here?
How do you know that?
Who tells everyone that kind of information? I'm like, wait, what's happening?
Because we only see you from here on up.
I am completely dressed today.
Yes, you are.
Yay.
Yes, you are.
From toe to the top.
You did a good
head.
Job.
Thank you.
I'm just playing. All right, we're going to see who's in the kitchen today. Our friend Chef Joe from Cafe Barbosa is back with us. And it smells like Grandma's Italian Kitchen in here. Joe, what are we making today?
Grandma's meatballs. We're making serious meatballs today.
All right. And Grandma, this really is her recipe?
Really, truly is her recipe. We serve this at Cafe Barbosa. Anybody who comes in, this is what they have first.
Oh, I like it. All right, well, we're going to learn some of Grandma's secrets today and make some meatballs. We can't wait to join you. Today is also Makeover Madness, so I want to introduce you to Denise.
Hi, I am a registered nurse. I recently suffered a stroke on February 10th. I also just got this nice pacemaker on March 8th, and I really do appreciate the opportunity to have this makeover.
Oh, it seems like Denise definitely needs some pampering. So she is spending time with our friends at Cutting Loose Salons, and we will bring her in a little bit later in the show and watch her transformation. So I'm glad she's doing something for herself.
Yes, it makes you feel so much better when you know you look as good as you can possibly look.
Absolutely.
That's why we have Mickey.
Yeah, I know. I always say it's not just what's on the inside, right? It's okay to want to feel good on the outside.
In the beauty industry, that's a good way to look at it. So that is okay. All right, it is time for our first hot topic. And you may soon have options on where to buy liquor in Florida. The state Senate is approving a bill that will allow grocery stores and other retailers to sell liquor. Currently, it must be sold in a separate small liquor store. So this is being called the Whiskey and Wheaties Bill. It will next be approved by the House. Now, opponents say these smaller local stores could be forced out of business. What are your thoughts?
I agree. They can't compete with the grocery store. You know, you go to the grocery store, you get wine and maybe beer, but you have to go to a liquor store to get certain types.
What about the smaller craft brands, though? You know, the grocery stores aren't going to carry absolutely everything. So I'm thinking yeah, the smaller stores can be
Yeah, but that's the problem. You're not going to, if I'm going to be able to get something similar at the grocery store, I'm not going to make that extra step to go to another store.
But in most states, you don't have to go to another store.
True.
In most states, it's in the grocery store.
Really?
And I think it makes it cost more when you have to have a separate store. So I think it would make liquor cost less. So a lot of people would really like that idea, I'm sure.
I don't think they're going to drop the price of liquor.
Well, it's state set, so for the most part.
I live in New York City, you guys, and I think Florida is a boozy town. I'm not going to lie, all right? Because like you actually have to go to a liquor store, and you actually have to, and that they sell beer, they sell liquor and wine. They don't sell beer. Beer you can buy at like a bodega, or you can buy it at like a grocery store. But it is kind of like another additional trip, you know, that you have to make. And it's kind of like interesting. Now you're going to go like grab your Wheaties and you're going to grab your Jack. Like
that's
it's kind of interesting to me.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just you're making it easier and easier to get boozier and boozier. I like
yeah,
it.
Yeah, no, it's
I
a good point. It's
you got to take responsibility.
Absolutely. All right, that's working its
We're
way
all okay with it.
Yeah, it is what it
two
is.
Two packs of Wheaties and one of booze.
I do feel bad for the smaller stores, but it will be convenient for, you know, say the consumer.
Absolutely. So how much money would you spend to watch a just released movie at home instead of going to the theater? So movie studios seem to think you'll pay a lot. There are discussions about charging $30 to $50 to view a movie at home while it is still in the theaters. So a cut of that money would then go to the entertainment venue that you did not go to. So the studios argue that people pay more than that to take their family to the movies. Would you pay it to stay home?
Okay, 30.
No, because right now they do it for 15 or 17. There's some places, some movies that actually are in the movies that are on Xfinity right now. You can download for $17.
I did one of those.
And I refuse to do $17 for one movie.
Yeah, but if there's like 10 of you.
Right.
So you're even,
but it's not 10 of me. It is me.
Well, it's definitely individual.
I did that because I went to the movie and it was $6 to get in and $17 for the Coke and the popcorn.
Yes.
So I would have been better off at home and I wouldn't have eaten that popcorn. So I would do it for 15 or 20, maybe 30. 30, but I wouldn't for 50.
I don't even know the last time I've been in a movie theater. I think it's like, have you ever seen the lights go on in a movie theater and look at the floor? Has anybody ever seen that? Like,
I do not enjoy the experience.
I do not enjoy it either.
That's
and if
why
I
they keep
have
it dark.
Like a really nice bottle of wine and have like a cheese board and sit
couch.
And watch a new movie with like two of my friends or special someone.
Well, you have places like Cinebistro that is actually really nice.
Yeah.
You don't have to worry about that and you get food.
But you still have looked at the floor, right?
And
you still
nice.
Have seen
nice.
The menu. I mean,
I
they do have like
good.
Nicer, they have nicer wines, but I'm like, it's kind of fun to be in your home, right?
And I mean, I don't mind the home thing. I just I find the price to be excessive if it's just one person. If it's just me, I don't want to pay $30 to watch a movie. That's not good.
Yeah, I think
that's not
I think the option is an okay thing to throw out there because some people like the experience of the music and the wide
screen.
Yeah,
I like
and all
the
that.
Big screen,
right.
And nobody's going to bother me. My phone, I'm not going to hear my phone ring.
That's
I'm
a good
just
point.
Really
Except
isolated.
The person sitting from the next to you.
You get to focus. You get to focus.
I don't go to those kind of movies. Thank you very much.
All right, well, we'll see if those options become more readily available. So, is it more difficult to date a really good looking person? According to a new study, being physically attractive increases the likelihood of a wrecked relationship. So Harvard asked women to judge attractiveness of men on photos. Then they tracked the relationship history. The more attractive were more likely to make lousy husbands and wind up divorced, according to this study. So then they tracked top actresses and powerful, attractive men on IMDb. The conclusion was that being attractive may make people who are unhappy in the relationships more likely to pursue alternatives because they can.
Because they can. I think that is the telling part. Maybe those other people would like to pursue those relationships, but they just
can't.
Aren't available to them.
Or they feel that this is, somebody is with me, and if I leave them, someone else might not want to be with me because they don't feel that they have that to
I
offer.
Agree with the study. I feel like being attractive gives you a sense of confidence where you feel like you can get away with a lot of things.
Yeah, entitlement. Mm-hmm. I deserve to have this.
Yeah.
Yes, my wife is fine at home, but I deserve to have this experience.
And
oh, you're gorgeous. You don't know the answer to this question.
Okay, first off, all right, back to New York City. There's so many beautiful women, and there's very, very little attractive men. And they end up being all of these very, like, halfway, middle-range dudes end up with these gorgeous girls, right? And it's because it's just slim pickings. So you're like, oh, he's got a great personality. Oh, he's great. And those guys are just as bad. So they'll go and they know what their options are. It's just what your options are. So I feel it's really, you know, even if you're not the most attractive person in the world, you're still going to leave your supermodel girlfriend because everyone gets sick of somebody sooner or later. You know what I mean? It's like, put it on
this
a five-year.
This is a scary statement for the married.
But I think this is, it's not just the attractive men. I think it's the same thing for attractive women.
Yeah, I think
a lot of attractive women, they do things that they know they can get away with.
Yes.
And they are more apt to not stay in a tough situation because there are other options. Like, why am I going to sit here and argue with you every day when I know I can find a man tomorrow?
Okay,
like,
but listen.
Why would I do that?
What if the guy you're dating, what if the guy you're dating is, like, really, really, really hot?
Yeah.
Do you worry more that he could be like, nah, you're annoying me today. I don't need to put up with this, as you say. Do you worry more?
I personally wouldn't, but I can see where some will, because if you don't have the confidence in yourself, you may think that you're not good enough for that person. But I think that, but being attractive causes other problems too, because then you have, if you're too attractive and the person isn't able to deal with it, they're always going to be worrying that you're cheating on them.
Right.
But I think that's a personality. I'm sorry. I think that's just a personality flaw. Like, you shouldn't be with somebody who you make them feel insecure or they make you feel insecure. It's just not right.
Like, you shouldn't, but the people don't go into a situation and say that. they don't say, oh my God, this person is so pretty that I'm worried that men are going to talk to her.
Okay, from my point of view, all this goes away. My mother once said, marrying a man for his looks is like buying a house for its coat of paint.
Yeah.
It's going to fade away.
We're only getting older.
Go for character and personality.
Yeah,
good advice. All right, and that is a good way to look at it, because when you match, do you remember the matchmaking television game? You were trying to make a love connection. I love this show. The love connection aired from the mid-80s to 90s. Remember this guy, Chuck Woolery? He used to say, we'll be back in two and two. The show is now reconnecting with viewers. Thank you very much, Bobeth. Yes, that looked like me in the 80s, and that was not me. But now it's going to be hosted by Andy Cohen. Would anybody watch this show again?
I watched it then, and Andy Cohen, come on, it's going to be amazing.
I said. Andy Cohen is gorgeous, from Bravo, very hip, very young.
And witty.
Just the concept that we are actually dating and having conversations, real human
people. Who
knew we still did that? I love that they're bringing it back.
Yeah.
I like that.
I think it's great.
Sounds boring to me.
Really?
You never watched it originally?
Yeah, I did, but I was a lot younger then.
She doesn't want a love connection right now.
I do not. And I do not want a love connection, so I wouldn't go, and I might find one.
And I have a love connection, but it's nice to hear other people's experiences.
Yeah, and it's like a rapid-fire bachelor, bachelorette. That's basically all it is. It's like, bam.
And it's cleaner.
Yeah,
They're not off in the hotel rooms.
Yeah, I mean, basically.
Mooching somewhere.
Right.
Yeah.
It's a cleaner, more wholesome bachelor, which I like. So, all right, we'll see.
Well,
it's coming out. We'll see what happens. All right, we're going to check out our happy hour forecast, and so much fun when we come back. Sinbad is in the studio.
Great to see you on this Friday afternoon. I'm meteorologist Josh Donen for Bob Harrigan today. Wow, look at the temperature outside. 80 degrees. Our average for this time of the year is 77. So, once again, just like yesterday, we are above that. Yesterday's high was 85. I don't think we're going to be that warm today, but still, we'll take the lower 80s, looking really nice. A few clouds out there, and the dew point right now at 51 degrees, humidity at 36%. As far as our Titan radar, well, it's quiet. A little different story yesterday, but not today, with drier aloft now, high pressure in control. As far as the winds go, we have winds on Longbow Key sustained 11 miles per hour, Anna Maria Island 12 miles per hour over there, and a little bit further south, 13 miles per hour in Harbor Heights. So winds a little bit gusty, especially offshore, but they're going to calm down. As far as our overnight lows, we're dipping down to the mid to lower 60s tonight.
Our next guest got his big break as a finalist on Star Search. And then he went on to star in 5 movies, to appear in dozens and dozens more, and become a very successful stand-up comedian. And we are thrilled to welcome Sinbad.
Good to be here.
What a
thrill.
Welcome back. I'm back with you guys.
It's great to have you back at McCurdy's.
I know.
We're so lucky to get you.
I'm blessed.
Actually, the last time you here, I feel like, was just yesterday. So I feel like you're part of the family.
I was here yesterday.
You were
I was just here yesterday.
So what's your thoughts when you roll into Sarasota? Happen in town?
Oh, I rolled in last night, drove in from Orlando, tried to stop through McDonald's, and they let me sit there for about 10 minutes. And then the woman said, we're closed.
Everything's a little slow.
She let me sit there for 10 minutes at the speaker. And then I finally went up to the window. She was like, can I help you? Because we're closed. I said, you could have said something while we were just sitting there for 10 minutes. She said, we didn't know what you were doing. And I said, I'm in Sarasota.
I'm back. Was it somebody my age with white hair?
No, was a young girl. Purple hair, had earring in the nose, everything.
I tell you.
Things here run on a simple level.
It's a very simple level. Like, we're not going to tell you what clothes, figure it out. You know, you can sit here all night if you want. But it stopped me from getting the chocolate shake, which I didn't eat. Mm-hmm. So I'm getting better because she said they shut down at midnight. It's good for you to know. They shut down the shake machine at midnight.
All we're never out after midnight. We don't need to know.
That's right. There was no one out. There were no dogs out. There were no animals. There were no birds. There was nothing.
The whole city shuts down.
Everything was shut down.
Where do you live? Where did you come from?
I live in L.A.
Oh, okay.
Where
from
things
Michigan.
Don't shut down at midnight.
No, but you know, L.A. is not as hip as people think it is. L.A. is all right. New York is what's happening. New York never shuts down. New York, you can stop by 11 o'clock. Want to get something to eat? You go left, you go right.
That's right there.
You have something to do. L.A. is like this. L.A. shuts down at 1.
Yeah.
You got to drive it worse. You're not going to walk around. So it's not as simple as people think it is.
I actually walked in L.A. once, and I was like during the Oscars. I was walking around just to go like pick up a dress, and everyone stopped the car and stared at me. They were like, "Wait, why are you walking? Like, what are you?"
Yeah.
And
do
I was
you need
just...
a ride? Do you know, are you okay? Are
meanwhile,
you okay?
There was like a poodle on its hind legs walking next to me, and everyone was looking at me, and I'm like, "What?"
That's too funny, man.
Well, you know,
that's
you're lucky LA. Because McCurdy's is open late, so there will be lots and lots of people to see you.
Right, but then afterwards, we're just gonna stand outside. We want to start something new, just standing outside. Just get people used to
shock
people. Yeah, we're just going to stand outside.
And talk.
So people get used to people being outside. So we'll stand outside.
Don't be noisy, because that is not allowed.
I know, there's
after
a noise
10.
Ordinance.
Yes.
But there's no police to get you after 10. So there's no police out.
Yeah.
So there's no one out. So there's no one here to enforce the law.
So we could be okay. We could make noise out there.
We could make noise.
You don't think anybody's
going
to be
able to
hear us.
No one's tested it.
All right.
We'll take that.
We're going to test it now.
I will take that.
And no one will hear you because they all have sleep apnea masks. So no one's going to hear you talking.
Oh, look up at all those condos. One of those lights is going to go on.
And that little mask. Hey! And put the little mask back on.
Is that Sinbad down there?
Yeah.
I'm thinking you don't think we're real hip, but that's all right. You know what we are good at? We're good at food. The restaurants here are outrageous.
I know.
You came on meatball day.
It smells so good. You broke down and started eating it.
Yeah.
I'm gonna bust you.
I'm gonna bust you. Check
it out. Look, she went and broke down and got it. Yes.
She went and begged you.
She went and broke down.
I was telling everyone my business. I was hungry.
Because there's a meatball on my foot.
See, everybody else has meatball etiquette. We'll wait for the show. And she just went over there.
Well, I mean, since you already brought it out.
She went over there, and then she did a little sexy thing. Hey, Joe. I'm so hungry.
Oh. I did not do that.
Joe, oh, God.
That's that beautiful people.
Yeah. She
pulled the pretty people card.
But I was really hungry. Because
y'all were talking about, do people want to date ugly men? What are y'all talking about?
Potential.
That's what I'm talking about. You don't want to date somebody that looks too good. Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Do you get that all the time? People don't want to date you because you look too good?
No, I'm married, so I'm ruined. So I'm wrong. Y'all don't want to date ugly dudes. Stop that.
Would you date an ugly woman?
What would you call ugly?
What do you call ugly?
If she has a goatee that like me, if she has a goatee and looks like she could be in the circus, we're not going out.
We've got a lot of people in the circus.
I know, this is the circus area. This is circus
college. But you live in the land of
beautiful
people.
Just watch the street, you'll see something.
You live in the land of beautiful people.
Yeah, beautiful, and you can get yourself fixed up to be beautiful. See, L.A., you don't have to come there beautiful. They'll rebuild you.
Well, we got that here, too. We're really good at fixing here.
No, but Naples, they fix it even more.
They do.
Because nobody's over 20. Everybody's like, oh, God. So nobody's over 20 in Naples.
Very true.
Well, I think I better move to Naples. Sinbad, we want you to play a game with us.
Okay.
This may get ugly.
Okay.
But we want you to stick around and play a game with us.
Does it require fighting?
It doesn't require fighting.
Okay,
no.
I was right.
Now, he's going to be at McCurdy's late at night, McCurdy'sComedy.com, to find out more when you can see Sinbad. He'll be there through March 26th, early and late. And we'll be right back and play a game with Sinbad.
That's right. Dating ugly people.
The Sarasota Film Festival is March 31st through April 9th, featuring independent films from around the world, panels, parties, and conversations with stars, all happening in downtown Sarasota.
You don't want to miss it, so get your festival guide and choose the films and events you want to attend.
Buy your tickets online, by phone, or at the Hollywood 20 box office. They go fast, so get them now.
So join us to see and be seen.
the human spirit's capacity to defy the odds, to push the envelope, is boundless.
They're coming from Tampa, Fort Myers, even Orlando. They're coming from everywhere for the Sarasota Ford Promise. Our promise means a new car you'll love. If not, return it for one you do. At Sarasota Ford, we promise live market pricing. We monitor national pricing on our entire inventory, so you get the best deal. In fact, we guarantee it. Bring us any competitor's ad, and we'll beat it by at least $1,000. That's why they're coming from everywhere to Sarasota Ford, where 41 meets 301. SarasotaFord.com.
I'm calling in regards about my mother, and I'm here, and I just want to thank you because it saved my mother's life yesterday. And I'd like to know the names of the people that came in and saved her so I could call and thank them. And she's doing fine. It's a wonderful thing. Thank you.
When you fall and cannot get up, an accident can turn into a tragedy. But with Life Alert, one touch of a button can get you help fast. Life Alert saves a person from a catastrophe every 10 minutes.
Life Alert is a lifesaver. If it weren't for Life Alert, I wouldn't be sitting here today.
For a free Life Alert brochure, call 1-800-962-4112. That's 1-800-962-4112. Call now, 1-800-962-4112. For a free brochure, call 1-800-962-4112.
The human spirit's capacity to defy the odds, to push the envelope, is boundless.
Welcome back. We're going to have a lot of fun. So the Match Game has had a successful revival. You can see it on ABC7 Wednesdays at 10 o'clock. So we're going to play our own version of the Match Game with our celebrity guest, Sinbad. Here's how it's going to work. Les and Pam McCurdy are here to help. Les, you're going to ask the questions. And our job is to write down what we think Sinbad will say.
Okay.
Then he'll reveal his answer, and we get a point.
We're going to get in his head.
So get in Sinbad's head.
You can't know my mind.
We're going to get in your head. Les, let us have it.
I'm a little upset I don't have that long stick mic like I'm supposed to.
I know. The skinny mic.
All right, all right. A question is popping up on this camera right over here, I believe. The new soap opera. Oh, okay. We're launching a new soap opera to rival The Young and Restless. It's called The Old and the Blankless. The Old and the Blankless.
Okay, we're starting down with Mickey.
Mickey.
I'm still writing.
How long is
ready?
It?
Go
yes.
for it.
Yes. All right. The Boogie Oogie-less. Okay, Mickey. Yeah. There we go.
That's okay.
We just showed a little bit.
I know more about old people than she does.
Linda?
The old and the clueless.
The clueless.
Yes,
that's nice, nice. Bo Beth? The sexless.
What?
No, that didn't count.
I went clueless.
Clueless.
Oh.
Okay.
Another one.
The sleepless. And I went braless, ladies and gentlemen. The old and the braless.
I said useless.
That's horrible.
The next question, please.
Okay, and by the way, these are actual questions from the game right now.
Oh, that's right.
They're actually actual questions. We borrowed them.
Okay. And the next question is, Les and Pam were the strangest couple on the dance floor. Everyone else was dancing cheek to cheek, but they were dancing blank to blank. Les and Pam were the strangest couple on the dance floor. Everyone else was dancing cheek to cheek. They were dancing blank to blank.
All right, two answers, everybody. We need two answers. Mickey. We're starting with Mickey.
Mickey.
Yeah.
Tongue to tongue. Ooh, you know us well. Okay.
Toe to toe.
Toe to toe.
More like a boxing match.
Butt to butt.
There's another one.
Butt to butt.
Butt to feet.
Butt to feet.
Because Les fell down.
That's a good one.
Butt to feet. I admit defeat. All right. On the airplane, Stephanie said to Bo Beth, I don't have much confidence in this airline. I just saw the pilot, and he had a blank sticking out of his pocket.
Okay, actual questions with names changed, I've decided. They've changed the names to incriminate us.
Okay. Mickey, are you... A selfie stick sticking out of his pocket.
A disabled parking sticker.
A disabled parking pass sticking out of his pocket. Bo Beth does not know how to spell well.
Don't worry about it.
Just say it.
Phonetic. Just phonetic.
Just say it. Just say
it.
A flask.
Okay.
A flask sticking out of his pocket. A banana sticking. A breathalyzer. A support cat sticking out of his pocket.
It's a map.
All right.
Do we have time for one more?
Yes.
All right. Off we go. Dun, 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 dun. Sinbad starred in the holiday film Jingle All the Way. If the movie was filmed in Sarasota, it would be called Blank All the Way. Blank All the Way.
I love this question. All right, Mickey. Sarasota. Title of the movie. She's writing.
That's
a long.
She's going.
It's coming. It's coming. It's called Single Old People All the Way. Linda, you're the expert.
Stumble all the way.
Sleep all the way. Jiggle all the way.
Limping.
And complaining all the way.
Tingle all the way.
Oh, almost. So close.
You played this before.
So close. All right, let's do one more.
One more. All right, this is it. All right, here we go. Sinbad was a finalist on Star Search.
Just bring that up.
Yeah, that's a memory we wanted to forget. In the best comedian category, Linda Carson could be a finalist in this category. Sinbad was a finalist on Star Search in the best comedian category. Linda Carson could be a finalist in this category.
The best what?
Okay, Mickey.
Best
goat topple. Very nice. Well, I didn't even know it was called a topple.
She toppled.
The best stripper. The best stripper category.
I
know that about you.
I didn't write one yet.
That's okay.
Well, Beth is awestruck.
We'll come back to you.
I went with the best sex story.
Best sex stories. Best
hair helmet.
Hair helmet.
I got one of those.
Best swinger.
Best bucket list.
Best bucket list.
All right, good one.
And
all
I just put Sinbad on.
Of course, Sinbad just met her, so we don't want to.
Sinbad knows more about Linda than you know.
He's writing a story.
I was finishing up. Y'all had answers already before I could even have an answer.
Here we go. I'm not going to
The answer is.
And what is it?
Linda.
I was
going to
say the would best be what? Sexy masseuse category.
Oh, alrighty then.
Stripper masseuse.
Right. Stripper masseuse and swinger. It's all at the airport,
it
ladies
is.
And gentlemen.
All right, big thanks to Sinbad for hanging and playing the match game with us. And you can see him on stage at McCurdy's this weekend through the 26th. For tickets, go to McCurdy'sComedy.com. Hey, Sinbad, you may want to stick around. We are having a swimwear fashion show next.
I'm wearing a thong.
All right, okay. Alrighty then.
Thong, baby.
Visual. Maybe they will be too. Stay with us.
Men and women should share the same bathing suit.
At the same.
With a top prize of $10 million, the new $10 million world-class cash scratch-off from the Florida Lottery is your ticket to take on the world. $10 million world-class cash scratch-off from the Florida Lottery. One of our life-changing scratch-offs offering billions in cash prizes.
Hey, Tampa Bay, join us for the premiere of a new St. Petersburg tradition. The St. Petersburg Seafood and Music Festival, happening Saturday and Sunday, March 25th and 26th from 10 to 8 p.m. at Nordstrom Park. Savor mouth-watering Florida Gulf Coast seafood dishes by top restaurants and chefs while you enjoy great live music from some of Florida's top musical groups. So grab your family and friends for the St. Petersburg Seafood and Music Festival, March 25th and 26th. For more information, visit seafoodfestivals.com.
It snows.
small wonder anybody loves it all.
I just love art that moves me.
No small.
I mean, really moves me.
Wonder.
Sunset Fiat of Sarasota presents No Small Wonder, high performance style. Let the art of Fiat move you.
An important message for Americans eligible for Medicare.
Are you receiving all the benefits available to you? Now's the time to find the coverage that's right for you at the right price. The way to do that is to explore your options. You can spend hours doing that yourself, or you can call Health Markets and let us do the legwork for you.
Let us find you the right plan at the right price and see if you qualify to lower your prescription costs.
Put our free service to work for you at no charge.
Call 1-800-738-1923.
You know, things can happen in an instant. We never expected Brady to be in an accident. And if he didn't have blood donors, he wouldn't be here.
To Suncoast blood donors and everybody in this community, I'd say thank you. You know, I'm gonna pay it forward.
If you've ever had a bad night's sleep, call and price the new Craftmatic Legacy. It has so much more than other adjustables and still costs up to 50% less. Featuring a rising adjustable pillow rest to support your head, neck, and shoulders, bedside power plugs, underbed night lights, and more. So call and price one today for less, up to 50% less than Tempur-Pedic Sleep Number and other adjustables.
You get so much more and it still costs less. You gotta see how little they cost.
Call 1-800-774-8103. That's 1-800-774-8103. Call now.
Welcome back to Suncoast View. We're going to check in with Chef Joe from Cafe Barbosa, who's in there sampling the Sunday sauce. I'm catching you. So tell me about Grandma's Meatballs Sunday sauce. What was her routine like to get all this ready?
On Sunday morning, she would start at 7 in the morning, and she would go and cook until 2 in the afternoon. So the whole meal took 7-8 hours to cook and 15 minutes to eat. You know why?
Why?
You know, Italians, they eat like they're going to jail.
Because they could be, right?
That's right.
Yeah, you never know.
Likely.
Well, we eat like that too, and we are headed over to you in just a few minutes. Bobette?
Well, the warmer temperatures mean the beginning of beach season, so it's time to refresh and update our swimwear styles. And Suncoast designers Jamie Paul and Roxanne Hollihan have developed their own brand of high-end designer swimwear, and they're joining us today to tell us about swimsuit trends. All right, guys, so when you talk about swimwear trends, you know, what's trending?
Well, for me, being a California native, recently moved to Sarasota, and this is the new West Coast in my eyes, Sarasota is.
So no longer LA, now it's Sarasota.
And I love this place here. It's year-round swimwear, beautiful weather, and being a native Californian, I designed the debut collection for Liz Claiborne Swimwear 20 years ago.
So oh, wow.
I've been in this business for 20 years. I've designed for Tommy Bahama, Quicksilver, all types of people. When Roxanne and I met, she said, let's get something going, and this is the perfect spot for
you
it.
You thought she meant swimwear.
Well, I like that.
Well, okay, so I have a question. You've been doing this for 20 years. I mean, are there really that many different things to do with swimsuits?
Yeah, because it's
only this much fabric.
You're never going to reinvent the wheel. It's how do you put little twists to it.
Oh, okay.
And that's what we do.
Well, what makes you guys as different? Like, what are you doing, like, trend-wise as far as colors and fabrics?
Great question. Colors, white ground, the purple iris print. She has a gorgeous orchid display
this
in our backyard, and we get a lot of inspiration from Mother Nature and the ocean.
Right. Oh, beautiful.
So we are seeing florals. I know we're big in fashion right now. Mm-hmm. That's transferring over to swimwear as well.
And you said your designs are made here on the Suncoast, but how does it work with California? Because I think you have a California connection too, right?
Our fabric comes from California. We manufacture in Tampa, Florida.
Oh, okay,
made
so you
in the
bring
USA.
The jobs here.
American made.
Exactly.
All right, well, you talked about the trends, but you have examples of them. So we're going to start a fashion show and bring out the models, and you show us what's trending.
You got it.
So who's first?
This is Megan. And she's wearing Iris Monokini.
I like the color.
So there's that floral print you were talking about.
Beautiful color.
And then it's not like a regular full body. It has a little bit of a reveal to it.
Exactly, exactly.
And so sometimes less is more.
We say business in the front, party in the back.
Okay, I love that.
I like Well, all right. Thanks, Megan. And who's next?
This is Leanne, and she is wearing our Orlando retro bikini. This is our tribute to the victims of Pulse nightclub.
Oh, how nice, with the rainbow.
Yes.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yep. That's great. And retro, is that because of the style of the neckline? Or where does the retro feel come
she
in?
She has the dolphin pants.
Yeah.
Takes you back to early 80s.
Oh, sure.
The little.
Yeah. Like the piping.
Yes.
The piping. Yes. Okay. That makes
Very
sense.
Cute. I like all that right. one.
And all a little right. bit of coverage on top, too. That's nice.
Exactly.
Not all out.
But none on the back.
Speaking of nice.
This is Jared.
All right, Jared.
His face Sad. Is turning red.
This is a custom shirt that I actually hand painted.
Okay.
It was about 30 hours worth of painting.
Wow.
And then with the European clientele that is here in Sarasota, we definitely love to have the retro Euros, the classic box cut men's Euros.
So more like boxer briefy style swimwear.
The tight
exactly.
one. Okay. All right.
And so you said because of the European clientele here, you are seeing these popular men do wear them here. They're not self-conscious on the beach or at the pools.
Traditionally, it's a tough sell, but with the European men, they wear it. It's from Brazil. So the
so visitors coming in wear these.
What about stuff that are smaller? Are they buying like the smaller bikini ones?
Oh, we don't do the banana hammock.
No banana hammock.
We leave that to the other people.
Good answer.
Oh, now this is it.
This is Jessica.
We love.
And she is wearing our newest style. This is the Mai Tai bandeau. These straps, you can tie them any which way.
Okay, yeah, show us some examples. It's very flattering.
It is. That's gorgeous.
I love the distraction.
Yep. Oh.
So,
for a I'll
just
customer.
Take this around.
Yeah.
And then I'll be turning.
So you have options. It. You can cinch it at the waist. Yeah. You can take it up.
Exactly.
You probably do one shoulder.
Yeah.
Multiple ways.
That's a great swimsuit.
It is.
All right, let's invite all our models back up and get one more look at all of the different designs.
Hello.
Oh, I see that you took off your shirt there. All right, well, you guys are actually having a trunk show coming up April 2nd at 2 to 5. And so you can get more details from that at your website. And if you want to go to their website for the latest swimwear collections, you want to go to jphollahandesigns.com and get more information about their designs and their trunk show. Next, Mickey brought a new FDA-approved weight loss method to tell us all about. We'll be right back.
ABC 7 News at 7, weeknights. From our studios on Florida's Suncoast, this is an ABC 7 News Update.
Hello, I'm Scott Dennis. Here's what's coming up at 5 o'clock. A big problem for the U.S. Coast Guard in Southwest Florida. How hoax callers are keeping crews from answering real distress calls.
Good evening, I'm Adam Cellini. The gun that three students brought to Booker Middle School was stolen from these apartments, according to police. We'll have more on their investigation coming up at 5.
That's a good check on the weather with Josh Stone.
All right, checking this weather. Beautiful conditions right now. 80 degrees, a few clouds out there, but we're seeing peaks of sunshine, obviously, on this Friday afternoon. Dew point at 51, humidity at 36. The winds, though, a little breezy out of the east at 15 miles per hour. Nothing to show you in the radar. A little different story yesterday, but not for today. High pressure in control. So we're going to have the wind start to calm down in the overnight. And as far as your overnight low is dropping down to the low 60s.
The official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC 7. We're here for you.
Oh my goodness, look at that.
He has about a 4.5 foot wingspan, and he weighs close to 4.5 pounds, so he's a very big bird.
Guess who is stopping by this week on Animal Outtakes?
Outdoor living is one of the greatest perks about living in Florida. So whether this is your style, or this, or maybe this, contact Superior Pools. They've been building pools from Sarasota to Naples since 2001, and they would love to build yours.
It's the season of savings right now during the Spring Clearance Event at Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota. Come shop the Suncoast largest selection of new Jeep Wranglers or stop by today and drive away in a 2017 Jeep Cherokee for just $18,999. And for a limited time, get America's best value, a new Dodge Journey for as little as $16,599. Better prices, bigger selection. Go to Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota.
Welcome back. We are one step closer to the big makeover reveal. Denise looks fabulous. We can't wait to see what Nikki has in store from Cutting Loose. We'll see her in just a few minutes. So losing weight, even with diet and exercise, is no easy task, as we all well know. So today, our beauty expert, Mickey Williams, has information about a new FDA-approved weight loss system that helps our stomachs feel full so we eat less. I love the concept, Mickey.
Yeah, ladies, this is a game changer. When I first saw this presentation a couple of weeks ago, I was just kind of like, this is absolutely going to change the way that people who have obesity, people with those BMIs that actually, you know, they've done the diet, they've done the exercise, and they really need to make that kind of change, but they can't do it. This is going to change everything. This is the game changer, and it's called Obalon. And this is the first swallowable intragastric balloon. So basically what you do is you're going to swallow a balloon. Take a look at this. So how this works is it's folded into a capsule and then swallowed by the patient right here. This is Adina. She's swallowing it.
So it's like swallowing a pill.
Swallowing a pill. Now, what happens is there's no sedation. There's absolutely zero anesthesia. You see her. She's right there. And what happens is it goes in with this micro catheter attached with it. So you drink a lot of water. You swallow this capsule. And then remotely, this little tiny balloon in your stomach, they remotely inflate it with a gas, okay? And this is via that micro catheter that they put it in there. Now, what's incredible about this is then that balloon basically is buoyant. It's about the size of a small orange. And it floats up, and that's going to sit in your stomach. Now, most people have about 3 balloons put in there. It's a 6-month process. Again, what we're talking about, non-surgical, and this is fully reversible. There's basically, you know, we've seen procedures like this in the past where you have to be knocked out. This is unbelievable. And what's great about it is they remove that catheter, and this like light kind of balloon fills up that little cavity. And then after a couple of weeks, you have another one put in. And then basically over 3 months, you have 3 balloons in your stomach. So you go ahead and, you know, you have that
satiated feeling
when you eat. And I was actually with the patient the other day, and she said, listen, it's great because I'm eating, but I'm watching what I eat. They also go and see a nutritionist. It's an incredible system. Like, again, this is like the game changer. And when I was at the event, I got to meet one of the patients who was actually in the trial. And she said, Mickey, I got to talk to her the whole time. She said, this has just changed my life. I'm healthier. I've lost the extra weight. I was able to kind of go out. Now I exercise more. I know about what I'm eating. Look at her. This is unbelievable.
Wow.
And what's just beautiful. She's just glowing because she said, now that I have this extra weight off, I can exercise. What's really incredible is the procedure takes less than 10 minutes.
Oh. Now who
less
is
than
eligible?
10 minutes. Basically, this is actually what's great. You know, you're going to have a BMI of 30 or 40, basically, kilograms. And what's incredible about it is, you know, it's not going to be just a supermodel who wants to lose weight. You're going to have to have, you know, be
a
considered
obese.
Yes, exactly. And what they found after 6 months, people were able to keep 89% of that weight off after they had those balloons removed. And you know how you take them out? It's as simple as an endoscopy.
Oh.
What's incredible is it's so absolutely brand new right now. And I was just like, this is going to be the most amazing thing. But one of the biggest doctors who was actually part of the trials is right here in Fort Myers.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's absolutely
incredible. So if it's something that someone is interested in doing, there's a doctor in Fort Myers that works with Obalon.
Yeah, and he actually swallowed the balloon himself. He told us that
so
at the
good.
Launch because he wanted to see what it felt like and what the experience would be like. His name's Dr. Shia. He's absolutely hysterical, but it was really an incredible kind of, you know, it's just incredible. I think that this is going to help so many people through have just tried with diet and exercise for so long.
Yeah,
they're going to be able to get that little bit of, you know, that weight down to where they can live these healthy, you know, wonderful lives.
Weight loss is life-changing.
It really is. This is the future, and it's that easy. Like I said, 10-minute procedures.
All right, thank you, Mickey. For more information on the Obalon Balloon System, you can go to obalon.com. Coming up next, our makeover reveal. Stay with us.
I knew I could get myself out of this. I just needed some hope and some help.
I took the first step to recovery when I made the call.
If you're depressed, drinking, and using drugs, you may need help. And the Affordable Care Act guarantees coverage of substance abuse. Call the Addiction, Hope, and Helpline now for a free assessment.
I had problems just getting to sleep, drinking, and using pills every night.
I feel like I'm losing control. I'm afraid I'll lose my job or even my family.
Are you losing hope? You can recover and get back on track. Call now for hope and help with proven gentle recovery programs.
I never thought that I could be somebody who didn't drink and use drugs.
I have something to hold on to for strength. I'm in recovery, getting the help I need.
Call the Addiction, Hope, and Helpline now for a free assessment with someone who cares.
Call 1-800-764-8708. That's 1-800-764-8708.
Car experts and customers agree. There's a whole lot to love about a new Subaru. Subaru was named the 2016 Best Overall Brand, Most Trusted, and Best Performance Brand by Kelley Blue Book. And ALG named Subaru its top mainstream brand for residual value for 2016. Now you can lease a new Subaru Outback for just $229 a month or get 0% financing during the Subaru A Lot to Love event. Get more for your money. Go to Sunset Subaru in Sarasota.
You only have one life. Are you gambling with it? One in three adults have high blood pressure. Not knowing your numbers could cause you to lose big time. Luckily, you can turn the odds in your favor by getting your blood pressure checked today. Don't leave your health to chance. Learn more at heart.org/HPB.
I'm calling in regards about my mother, and I'm here, and I just want to thank you because it saved my mother's life yesterday. And I'd like to know the names of the people that came in and saved her so I could call and thank them. And she's doing fine. It's a wonderful thing. Thank you.
When you fall and cannot get up, an accident can turn into a tragedy. But with Life Alert, one touch of a button can get you help fast. Life Alert saves a person from a catastrophe every 10 minutes.
Life Alert is a lifesaver. If it weren't for Life Alert, I wouldn't be sitting here today.
For a free Life Alert brochure, call 1-800-962-4112. That's 1-800-962-4112. Call now, 1-800-962-4112. For a free brochure, call 1-800-962-4112.
And it's time now for our makeover reveal. This is Denise. Take a look at this picture. This is Denise when she first came in this morning. She stopped by cutting loose a couple of hours there, and let's see what happened. Come on out, Denise. She has not seen herself yet, so this is new to her. Okay, take a look in the camera and see the new Denise.
There you are.
What do you think? Oh, my goodness. You are gorgeous.
Thank you.
You look 10 years younger. Wow, that's gorgeous. And of course, you've been working with Nikki B.
Thank you.
Now, she looks so good.
Doesn't she? Denise, when she came in this morning, she was so excited. Now, and as you heard, she had a stroke, and she now has a pacemaker. She gave Ashley and I the honor of naming her pacemaker. Yeah. She wanted to give it a name.
Got a name.
What's its name?
So we went with Sophia Loren because...
Sophia Loren.
Oh, my
gosh. I love your hair. Thank you.
It was actually our inspiration for her look today. Mm-hmm. She said, as long as I don't look like Honey Boo Boo... I want to look like Sophia Loren.
Tell us about the color, because that's really changed the complexion.
So if in her before photo, you might not be able to see, but she was pretty red. She had a lot of red going on in her hair. So what I did, I wanted to just tone it down, keep the warmth, but bring out some cinnamon tones. Mm-hmm. She's got this beautiful olive skin tone. I just wanted to warm it up and make her complexion pop. So we added some highlights as well, and those highlights are giving these beautiful cinnamon golden tones, mm-hmm. and then the nice neutral base to really just give everything that nice honey glow.
You look beautiful.
And the natural curl is stunning.
This is all hers.
Stunning, stunning. All right. Is she going to be able to recreate that? Like,
yes,
what did she do?
She told me she was great at her curl, so I just wanted to encourage the layering in her hair.
You are awesome. Thank you so much. Good job, Nikki Bee and Cutting Loose.
Thank you.
And now we're going to eat. We're going to the kitchen with Cafe Barbosa. Joe, we're on our way over.
Awesome. I can't wait either.
Get ready.
Check out mysuncoast.com/dining, your guide to the foodie lifestyle.
An important message for Americans eligible for Medicare.
Are you receiving all the benefits available to you? Now's the time to find the coverage that's right for you at the right price. The way to do that is to explore your options. You can spend hours doing that yourself, or you can call Health Markets and let us do the legwork for you.
Let us find you the right plan at the right price and see if you qualify to lower your prescription costs.
Put our free service to work for you at no charge.
Call 1-800-738-1923.
From our studios on Florida's Suncoast, this is an ABC 7 News Update.
Hello, I'm Scott Dennis. Here's what's coming up at the top of the hour. A danger to drivers on the Suncoast. The Florida Highway Patrol says someone is throwing rocks or shooting a BB gun at drivers on I-75 in Manatee County. At least three vehicles have been damaged so far. We'll have the latest on the search for those suspects. In Suncoast Traffic Watch right now, there's a lot of congestion on I-75 northbound lanes from Clark Road north to Fruitville. Now let's go over to Josh for another look at our weather.
All right, thanks, Scott. 80 degrees right now, a few clouds right now, and really comfortable conditions. Dew point at 51, easterly wind at 15 miles per hour, so a little breezy this afternoon. The radar remains very quiet, and our winds are going to calm down as we go through the overnight, but could pick up tomorrow morning. As for your evening planner on this Friday night, temperatures cool down into the mid to low 60s for the later evening hours.
The official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC 7. We're here for you.
For years, I've told everyone my Craftmatic adjustable bed was the greatest until I got the new Craftmatic Legacy. It has an adjustable pillow feature that's awesome. You're going to want one too when you see how little they cost.
If you've ever had a bad night's sleep, call and price the new Craftmatic Legacy. It has so much more than other adjustables and still costs up to 50% less. Featuring a rising adjustable pillow rest, bedside power plugs, underbed nightlights, and more. Available in all mattress types with optional heat and soothing massage for as much as half the price of Tempur-Pedic, Sleep Number, and other adjustables. Enjoy temporary relief of low back pain, nighttime heartburn, mild arthritis. Adjust the rising pillow feature to help align your head, neck, and shoulders. See for yourself with our 30-day in-home trial. So call and price one today for less, up to 50% less.
You get so much more and it still costs less. You gotta see how little they cost.
Call 1-800-237-0214. That's 1-800-237-0214. Call 1-800-237-0214. Call now.
Attention blood clot filter patients. Surgically implanted blood clot filters are potentially life-threatening. Some filters are prone to breaking, resulting in pieces of the filter moving through the body and causing internal bleeding. If you had surgery to implant a blood clot filter, you may be entitled to a cash award, even if you haven't suffered side effects yet. Call the Gold Shield Group now, 888-747-5291, to see if you qualify for a cash award. 888-747-5291.
Luxury for less at Alex Karras Lincoln. Drive a brand new 2017 Lincoln MKZ Sports Utility for $249 per month or 2017 MKZ for $299 per month. We are proud to introduce the newest addition to the Lincoln lineup, the all-new 2017 Lincoln Continental. We have a great selection and ready for immediate delivery. Alex Karras Lincoln, affordable luxury, winner of the prestigious 2015 President's Award, serving Florida's Suncoast since 1978. We're located 2 miles north of the Sarasota-Bradenton Airport on US 41.
Outdoor living is one of the greatest perks about living in Florida. So whether this is your style, or this, or maybe this, contact Superior Pools. They've been building pools from Sarasota to Naples since 2001, and they would love to build yours.
Are you Goodwill?
Yes, because when I donate
or shop at Goodwill,
I'm creating a job.
I am Goodwill, yeah.
Welcome back. We're here with Chef Joe from Cafe Barbosa making some balls.
Making
some meatballs.
Grandma's meatballs.
Serious meatballs.
Oh, let's get it.
So here's what we're going to do. My grandmother, my mom's mom, she's from Northern Italy.
Okay.
And she had a special way of making her meatballs.
Okay. With love.
With love, a lot of love. And I have to tell you, you know, every Sunday, this was every single Sunday.
Wow.
Okay? But she would use three meats. Most people use just one. They use ground beef. She used ground veal, ground pork, and ground veal.
Oh.
So you could put that right into that bowl.
Plop.
All of them? Yep.
You guys, go on in, make
I'll
friends.
I'll crack the egg for you.
I love to see him do this with one hand. Look at that.
Yeah.
He's fancy.
Then you're gonna add a little bit of onion, half the onion.
Half the onion. My fingers okay?
Yes.
All right. I'm pawing it today, ladies.
A little bit of basil.
Like when?
That's it.
All right.
Some I'll little bit of garlic. One.
Get that
just
garlic
a little
in
bit,
there,
half.
Girl.
Yeah. No. Oh. Okay.
Whoa! You're
I'll put some back. I'll put some back.
I'm not making
I'll put
out with
more
you.
Back.
Salt, pepper, and
all
a little
all
bit of
that?
Chill fix. Yes, all okay. of that. Ricotta cheese.
You better go for this, Mickey.
All right,
I'm
a good scooper.
Whoa, back up. There's ricotta in the meatball?
In the meatballs.
What? I told you guys it was great.
Oh, sorry, Lynn, I threw some cheese on you.
I like grandma.
What else we got?
A little Reggiano Parmesan, the king of cheeses.
I'm a big Parm fan, so tell me when.
Can we use all that?
Go ahead, all of it.
Yeah, there we go.
We used all the garlic.
Now, a little bit of parsley. I'll take that. I'll do that for you.
He doesn't trust me anymore.
No, I don't. And then the big thing is, these are breadcrumbs, but we use fresh bread.
Everybody uses dry.
So when you use dry, right?
Your meatball's dry.
It's hard to
And
absorb.
Your meatball's heavy, right?
Yeah.
Oh. So what do you get fresh bread comes
fresh,
from?
You use fresh bread,
and
then you puree it, right? And then milk.
Oh.
Wow, grandma has some tricks.
Grandma wasn't like a three-ingredient meatball lady, was she? Can I mix it? Can I mix it?
You're going to town right now.
Then I'll help you with the balls.
Now you don't.
I bet she will.
Yes. You can hold it for her. There
I'll
you
hold
go.
It down. She gets excited.
You knew it was going downhill eventually.
Yeah.
I thought it was. I was surprised it didn't get there that earlier. So this is, I'm not trying to be gross. This is a really wet meatball because of the cheese, the milk.
Yes.
It's
a lot sloppier
than normal.
Yeah.
But I think that's what makes it moist. Right?
Yes, moist and full of love.
And not so heavy, you said.
Not so heavy. It's light.
I love
it. So I can eat more of them.
But you could do this. Like, if you want to saute it in a frying pan.
Okay.
You could put a little bit of, you know, vegetable oil, saute it. Then you could throw it raw in the sauce if you want.
You can?
Oh, you can. Just right into the sauce and let it go for about a half hour.
Oh, okay. You cook it half hour.
Then you could put it in the oven if you want for 375 for 15 minutes.
So all three of those steps need to happen.
Right.
Saute.
No, you can. You can do either one.
Okay.
Which one do you do?
Well, I'm going to put them in the oven at 375.
Well, I like not adding oil.
Yeah, because I don't want to get us all full of
oil. We got some balls going on.
Yes, girls, balls. Oh, perfect balls. These are perfect.
Are those too big?
No, honey, those are never too big.
So they're like tennis ball size.
There's about 3 ounces of meat.
Yeah.
Right? Perfect. Okay, that's good. We're going to just put this.
We got more balls over here.
Linda's in assembly line.
Let's put those balls on there.
There we go.
Okay. So we're going to put them in the oven for 15 minutes.
15 minutes.
Right?
Okay. I've got to remember this.
All right. But because of the magic of TV, you already put some in the oven, and now you put it in the sauce. Yeah, what are you talking about? You already put one in your mouth a half hour ago.
Wasn't it good?
Yes, it was. Share, good. People.
Okay,
share.
So here's what we're going to do.
Okay.
That's it. This is the meatball finished in Sunday sauce.
Okay. I'm going to walk this on down while you dish, girls.
What is Sunday sauce?
Ooh. Yeah, tell us mixed with Sunday sauce.
So sauce,
that's the sauce she made on
Sunday. There's two different types of sauces, right? The mother sauce is marinara.
Uh-huh.
The mother
which
sauce.
Has no meat or anything in it.
Okay.
But then there's Sunday sauce, which has veal, beef, pork,
which
pig
is everything.
Skin, which is everything,
sauce.
And it cooks for like 6 hours.
So this is meatballs with meat and the sauce on top of it?
Yeah.
Wow.
That's incredible.
Isn't that good?
Grandma's meatballs literally melt. I mean, they're not doughy or heavy at all.
No, not heavy.
So take us on a little tour of all the different things you are doing with meatballs. And I just wanted to go back to that shot we just had.
Yeah.
Because that is an amazing amount of cheese.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my goodness.
That looks great.
Well, I'm going to start over here.
Okay.
So this is the ultimate veal parmesan hero.
Oh, wow.
Right. Is that amazing?
Yeah.
That looks good.
That looks
Can I have a bite of that,
balls.
Actually?
Yeah.
Thank you.
You want to eat the whole thing?
There it goes.
You rock.
This is what I like.
Oh, my God.
You're going to need one of those balloons.
That's incredible.
That is impressive. Okay, so and then meatball on a salad?
So this is chopped salad. with balsamic vinegar and the meatballs right on top with the sauce. And when you mix it with the vinegar and the acid from the vinaigrette with the tomatoes, holy,
amazing. I'm going there. I claim that.
And then the ultimate spaghetti meatballs, right? Mm-hmm. With, you know, with even
gotta love that.
It's the best.
Yeah. Mm.
Okay.
That's just
baked raviolis with meatballs.
It goes with everything.
Our appetizer at Barboso, this is what we serve a ton of, is the house meatballs, grandma's meatballs with ricotta cheese on top. And then smash meatball pizza.
Of course.
With the ricotta and basil.
The red and sauce Sunday. Is the meatball. Oh my gosh. Chef Joe, Cafe Barboso. Mm. Amazing peasant Italian.
Thank
food.
You, girls.
And
appreciate
we
it.
We love grandma.
Wonderful.
We love
it.
Grandma's meatballs are absolutely amazing. Mickey, great to have you here.
Thanks, Mickey.
Linda, good work cooking in the kitchen. Everybody, we had a great time with Sinbad, remember? He is at McCurdy's through Sunday. Enjoy.
Happy birthday to you. And next week is the film festival.